So many of you might have seen the pre-market sessions every single trading day live on YouTube, 8:30 Eastern. If you have, you might ask, well, how can Tim kind of work through these stocks so quickly, consistently, breaking down all these criteria? Today, I'm going to give you the tools to do exactly what I do every day. Hey, everyone. Lead Trader with Stock Trade, Tim Bowen here. Be sure to like, subscribe, share these videos, and as always, ring that bell if you're on YouTube to be notified as soon as we drop a new video. I'm doing videos. Bryce is doing videos. Matt's doing videos. Kyle's doing videos. Jack's doing videos. We've got an amazing channel here. Ring that bell to be notified, subscribe, and share with your friends. All right, that being said, today I'm going to be talking about what I'm looking at every single day for that next great day trade, and I've got some resources for you. I give. Anyway, so couple things I want to point out. This is going to be probably, you know, a 7 to 10 minute video, kind of that sweet spot for YouTube. But the reason I'm doing this is mostly to give you the tools, but to also point out the fact that we have an entire day trading series for free at stockstotrade.com/free training. There's also a YouTube series. You can go on our YouTube channel. They're all there. Now, I prefer you go to stockstotrade.com/free training. You drop your email. You're going to get an email with the worksheet I'm working off of today. So whatever works for you. Hey, man, I'm here to please. But if you go to this webpage, sign up, and then the other nice thing, you'll get the worksheet. And then also, coming soon, I'm actually flying out in a couple days to record the swing trading and the short selling series as well. And they all have an accompanying worksheet, a journal, all the resources you need. So Day Trading 101 is live. It's there for you now. I'm going to be breaking that sheet down. And then also, if you're subscribed, if you drop your email in, you'll be notified as soon as swing trading and short selling drop. I think we're going to do swing trading probably in a couple weeks, and then a couple weeks after that, short selling. So go to that link, drop in your email, and let's talk. Okay, so now I'm going to explain what we look for a great swing trade. LIFE is going to be one of the focus today. Today I'm recording on September 16th, 2021. You know, depending on when you see this video, you should be familiar with this one. Was a huge runner all this week. You know, they dropped some super sketchy news earlier in the week, but the stock broke out on that. And then the beauty is they actually did an equity financing last night, which I won't wade into the weeds too much on that today, but you know, it's interesting the different world we're in. If you've been around like I have, you know, these offerings, these dilutions used to be the death knell for these stocks. I mean, once they did the financing, once they rang that register, they would never come back. They were killer short sells. Now, I mean, the crazy thing now, and I thank Wall Street Bets, I thank social media for this. So many people use that financing as a floor to then short squeeze these stocks. So they did the financing at 8. That was last night, you know. I mean, and here we are at 11 as I record. So anyway, that we'll save that for a different video. But this was a great day trade on pre-market prep this morning. We broke it down in detail. And then now I'm going to tell you, you know, what we look for. Okay, so here is that sheet. Keep in mind, you can screenshot it if you want. I mean, listen, again, I think most of you, this might, if this isn't your first video, you know, hopefully you know, I mean, something that I just, that's my life's mission right now. Yeah, I'm in a good place. I mean, and hopefully that doesn't sound like cocky or bragging. But, you know, I've got an amazing family. I'm in a great place in life. I'm semi-retired. I do all these videos. I trade my own money. I mean, it's just one of the things I really like is as I head into the twilight years, you know, I'm 63 and a half years old. I just love giving back. And everything I put out, I mean, you know, I put out podcasts, blog posts, you know, ebooks. I've got an ebook that I think, in my opinion, is worth hundreds, maybe thousands of dollars. We sell it for $18. Okay. I go live every day. I help out the Steady Trade team. I love giving back. So this is a sheet I've used probably for, I think I put this together, you know, this is when, probably roughly when I went full-time trading when I sold my company. I'm guessing I put this together probably 2012, 2013. So I've been using it, you know, going on 10 years now. And again, screenshot it if you want. I don't, if it helps you, that's what I want. You know, I'm not trying to, you know, whatever. I want everyone to be successful. That's one of the reasons you'll see me rant on social media all the time. You see all, you know, one of the reasons I go off on short sellers is, you know, they always want to laugh at the newbies and laugh at the true believers. You know, it's like, why? Why not try and help people? You know, why not? I mean, listen, if someone's a bag holder or if they're a true believer, why laugh at them? Why not try and help them? You know, why, you know, it's like, to me, it's like, driving by a homeless person, be like, ha ha, loser. Well, you don't know what situation they're in. You don't know why they're homeless. Why not stop and be like, hey, you know, you need some help. You know, listen, you need a ride. You need some money. You know, can I, or even if you don't do anything, you don't drive by and laugh. And that's why I go, if you follow my personal social media, I just go off and off on these people that short stocks. And listen, shorting is a viable strategy. I just told you, I've got a short selling course coming up, but I just don't understand the idea of laughing at people that make mistakes in trading. Hey, we all started somewhere. Anyway, bring it back to the worksheet, Tim. I just went crashing off into the weeds on this video. But anyway, let me step you through the criteria and why life matched these. Okay, so right off the bat, and I want you using these sheets every single day. And one of the big things I think that helps trading is repetition. So the more you step through these things, the better you can get. And here's what's great about the sheet. What I want you using this, print them out. I mean, I'm kind of a, you know, I'm old school. I like to handwrite. Or I've actually had people that have turned these into like Google Docs or digital formats. Again, do what works for you. I like tactile. I like writing things down. But, you know, fill these sheets out and, you know, do it for 3, 4, 5 stocks a day. And then ultimately trade that one stock that's the best setup. I mean, I know many of you are struggling with, you know, hey, there's 10 runners today. Which one? You know, especially if you have a small account, if you're under the PDT, you can't trade everything. You got to pick that, you know, that one. I mean, again, if you're under the PDT, best case scenario, it's one stock. I mean, especially if you can only make 3-day trades in a rolling 5-day period, you have to be selective. Because again, I mean, you're basically, you know, for to simplify the math, I mean, you're basically trading like every other day to keep from using up all 3 of your day trades. So you have to be selective. That being said, let's get started. Okay, Life. Yes, it's a low float stock. So we checked that box. We checked this box 3 days ago before it ran. We checked it again today. Is it up more than 10%? Again, this morning, stock was sitting at 850 in pre-market, but then once it opened, was trading at over 9. So it was already up 10% into that 945 window that I tell you to look at. So now you've got a 10% gainer plus. Next box is, let me jump back. Does it have unusual volume? And when I talk about unusual volume, what we're looking at is relative to the 60-day average. So in stocks to trade, right off the bat, if you run a default install of stocks to trade, you've got the 60-day average in your box. You can see the stock is trading. The average is 4 million shares today. I mean, we're trading 35 million as I record at noon. I mean, heck, it had one candle that traded 4 million shares this morning. So you can see you've got unusual volume. Is it a former runner? Heck yeah, it ran 2 days ago. You know, it ran on Monday. So it's a former runner. And actually, let me jump back just to show you. I mean, this stock is also, this is a 1-year chart. I mean, it ran December, big run, February, big run, decent run, March. So now you know, that, remember, day traders have good memories and we like to retrade the same stocks. So just in 1 year, this thing, and if you count the run from the other day, I mean, four times in a year, this is ran. I call that a former runner for sure. Is there a catalyst? Again, multiple catalysts with life. So the other day they dropped a PR, which again, the nice thing about stocks to trade is you can look all of this up. I'm trying to think what it was. Oh yeah. So lot of, you know, listen, I'm no doctor. Okay. Contrary to everyone on Twitter, I'm not a doctor, a virologist, or an epidemiologist, even though everyone on Twitter is. But you can see it is a positive FDA news for pulmonary sarcoidosis. I apologize if I butcher that. But you can see a lot of good buzzwords. Any FDA news for a low-priced biotech is always positive. So this PR dropped 3 days ago. So we've got a positive FDA PR. And then again, last night, they did that equity financing, which again, if I scroll through the news, you can see right here, it closed and they got $75 million in cash. Straight cash, man. I mean, that's what penny stocks need, okay? And everyone will say, oh, dilutions are toxic. But listen, this company isn't going anywhere. And they can do more R&D. They can do more promotions. They can do more pumps, especially when they got $75 million in the bank. So now we've got multiple catalysts aligned with this stock, which is always a positive. Then we add in, is it a whole dollar, half dollar break? Let's jump back to that chart. 950. So 950 would have been that number one, that 9:45 a.m. level, take into consideration the time of day. 950 was also a break of the previous day's highs. Speaking of the ebook, that's a level we always look for. Then you probably would have risked down on VWAP, which would have been in the low nines. So now you're risking roughly 30, maybe 40 cents for a potential upside of what we look for is like $1.20. So that means you'd probably already be out of this trade at this point, unless you're greedy. But you can see it's pushing new high today. And I know I'm talking fast, but I'm trying to pack as much into this video as possible. But remember, as I'm talking fast, as I'm, you know, talking about risk to reward, trade plans, entries, exits, remember that course, stocksandtrade.com/free-training. It's, I think, 6 videos. So I slow down and give it all to you. I'm just trying to break down the sheet as fast as possible. Next, is there clear to support to set risk? Yes, that would have been VWAP. You could also go down as low as 9, which would again be that next whole dollar, half dollar level lower. Then when I talk about quality of the setup, the lower the float, typically the better for a day trade. I believe this is around 2 million float or 14 million float, 14 million float. So again, very low float in this day and age, 36 million shares traded. You got float rotation, and actually the float would have went up because they did the offering. So there you go. This was a lower float stock. That's the beauty of stocks to trade real time. Look at this thing explode. So remember when they did the financing that increased the float. It's a dilution. They issue shares, increases the float. So the other day, I believe, and you can fact check me, feel free. It was a couple million float before the offering. So next we break down the rating of the catalyst. FDA news is always good. If you go back to the beginning of the video, I said that these financings have been the beginning of the short squeezes. I would have given this probably a B plus when I did the sheet this morning. Then we talk about ideal setup. We already went through that. Then the bottom part of this sheet is for your trade journal. That's where you actually enter, write down where you entered the stock, what your goal was, what your stop was, and then ultimately what happened. You know, I kind of write in the margins, you know, what happened. So say my entry was 950, my goal was 1025 or 1075, my stop was 9 or low 9s. I would actually write that down and then write out what happened so that I could review at the end of the day, review at the end of the week, review at the end of the month. Yes, reviewing your trades is boring. Everyone hates it, but that's the hard work, the difficult work, the work behind the scenes is what separates losers from consistently profitable traders. So nobody likes doing it. Nobody likes watching film if you're a football, you know, if you're an NFL guy, but you put in that work, that behind the scenes work, that's what makes you better. So, all right, I think I went way over on my time. Hopefully you're still here. Drop me a comment. Let me know how high did life go today, by the way, September 16th. This thing is becoming, if you didn't take that morning trade, it's becoming an afternoon VWAP hold. So what we would look for ideally is this slows down a little bit and then comes together with VWAP and then perks a couple hours later into that 2 p.m. window. That being said, go to stocks2trade.com/free training. You'll get the whole video series. You'll get the sheet. I will promise you, those videos are less fast than this one. Just so much to go over in a short YouTube video. And then you'll also get notified of the swing trading and the short selling series upcoming. Have a great day, my friends, and we'll see you next time.